Hello everybody, welcome back to my channel where skincare is all about progression over perfection, because perfection doesn't exist. We're all familiar with Goop, right? Gwyneth Paltrow's brand. I've mentioned the brand a few times, especially when it comes to questionable products and things that have happened, like exploding candles, which you can watch the video about here. But for those who don't know, Goop is a kind of lifestyle and wellness brand that not only sell goop-owned brand kind of products, but is kind of like a cult beauty, Sephora, Space NK of wellness and, in my opinion, alternative medicine kind of brands. And because of this, it hasn't been without its controversies. Gwyneth Paltrow and Netflix managed to piss off everybody with a brain cell back in 2020 with the release of her Netflix documentary, which followed Gwyneth Paltrow, her team, the Goop team, as they explored the world of pseudoscience, beauty, and wellness. Along with the release of that documentary came the release of a lot of really questionable and, in some cases, is really dangerous products that left scientists and experts no choice but to speak out publicly about the dangers of these products and the danger of the wellness industry in general, eventually leading to Goop being slapped with a massive fine, basically for lying. So today I thought it'd be funny to take a look at some of the more questionable products that Goop have had to offer, as well as two really quite dangerous products that, one, they don't sell anymore, and two, they still sell. This is one that, like, when you even just Google Goop, comes up everywhere, and this is a psychic vampire repellent protection mist. And this was sold on Goop from a brand called Paper Crane Apothecary. When I saw this, I was like, this is really fun. It's like a gimmicky, kind of like funny Christmas gift, stocking filler, Halloween present. But no, this is like a serious thing. I need to always preface this when I say that whilst I don't personally believe in the powers of crystal healing, well, I kind of maybe do, I don't know. I do believe in things that we can't explain yet. I believe in ghosts, I believe in aliens, I believe in spirits, I believe in energies. I'm not about to use vampire repellent, but I believe in this kind of stuff. But I say that because this vampire repellent is a crystal infused mist that can protect itself against psychic vampires. Now, according to Wikipedia, a psychic vampire is a creature in folklore said to feed off the life force of living creatures. The term can also be used to describe a person who gets increased energy around others but leaves other people exhausted or drained of energy. We all know those people. Whilst they're not on Goop anymore, I did find their Etsy page and they say, banish those soul suckers. Is there a person in your life who seems to drain the life right out of you? You, my friend, are dealing with a psychic vampire. Spray the mist around your aura to evict them from your head and create a shield that they will not be able to penetrate. Now, the ingredients are important here. The ingredients are very important here, with the main ingredient, you know, in the rules of the inky list, the ingredient that is most in here is love. I mean, it's cute to say, you know, like, love and care has been put into this product, but you can't put it in the ingredient list. Is that illegal? I don't know. Someone ask the FDA. Someone give the FDA a ring. Then the second ingredient is Reiki. That's not funny. Is really bad. I feel like you can't legally put those things on an ingredient list, but this does look like they're kind of making it in their kitchen. Next is sonically tuned Revers osmosis water. We've heard of osmosis water before and the scam of that. If you don't know what that is, check out this video here because no one else did. Rose water, salt, charged crystal chips, aqua aura, pyrite, fluorite, ametrine, garnet, bloodstone, tiger's eye, labradorite, neumite, and clear quartz. What I do love is they do actually have a disclaimer on their Etsy page saying that this is not FDA approved. Now, it's almost £40 on Etsy and they no longer sell on Goop. So that's a little bit overpriced. This is the osmosis water again, but you can customize, you can message them and be like, look, this is something I'm struggling with emotionally or whatever. And they will make you a custom water, a custom mist, which I think is nice. Listen, if crystals are your thing, you might love this. The second product that grabbed a lot of headlines was the sex dust, because Gwyneth herself used to use this regularly. Now, this is from a brand called Moon Juice, and they say that sex dust is a tub of adaptogens for fire, libido, hormonal balance, and creative energy. Sex dust, copyrighted, is a libido supplement that combines 6 powerful adaptogens and herbs that target stress to support healthy hormonal balance. And they recommend having this with coffee or tea in the morning. Now, the weirdest thing about this isn't the claims. The weirdest thing about this is that moon dust is a liquid and not a powder. You would think that if it's dust, it's like powdery? I don't know. It has some really good reviews. 5-star to 3-star mainly, with people saying by the second day, my partner had excitement about sex again and more moisture down there. Recommend for any couple that may be struggling with frigidness. By the second day, I don't think things work that quick. You know, you can't take like, oh no, I guess peppermint tablets do. Another review says, really great. I feel such a major boost in my energy levels. I feel like my sex drive is up slightly for sure, but most notably is that I feel more energized and engaged. Even the 3-star review, it's still pretty decent. I can feel it, they say. Still new to me, but very encouraging so far. I'm 68 and thought I was done with romance, but life is funny that way. I also use brain dust regularly. Who doesn't want to be smarter? It's a great combo. I hate the pseudoscience, like, wellness industry. It's very, I know, it's like a little cult, you know? I feel like it is very elitist. But on the other hand, people do feel like their life improves by it. And honestly, I think, I know nothing about nutrition and medicine, so maybe there are some truth to some of the benefits that some of these things have. But I'm all for people using things within safety that isn't harmful, that makes them feel better, even if it is just a placebo. And for £30, you would get 12 servings, which, it's expensive. I think even if you don't know who Goop is or who Gwyneth Paltrow is in relation to Goop, everybody knows this candle. This smells like my vagina candle. Back in 2020, this candle kicked up a real fuss. It wasn't much of a fuss. It's just a good headline for people to talk about, and probably one of the first candles come out that claims it smelled like vagina or any kind of body anatomy. But yes, for £57, you could infuse your home with the scent of Gwyneth Paltrow's vagina. Well, not really. No, there's a story behind it. It's actually quite cute. It's quite funny. So this is a collaboration between Goop and a perfume brand called Heretic Parfum. And they are known for their unique scents. If you've ever picked up one of their candles, you know they're a little bit different to other candles that you smelt before. And in a nice way, Smudge and Dirty Grass, I think, are two of their more popular. And the This Smells Like My Vagina candle instantly sold out. It was very, very popular. And honestly, looking at some of the notes and the description, I'm not surprised. It was described on the Goop website as funny, gorgeous, sexy, and beautifully unexpected. It puts us in the mind of fantasy, seduction, and sophisticated warmth. The main notes being geranium, citrusy bergamot, and cedar, which are all my scents. I love them. I also think a lot of people just wanted a candle in their house that says, this smells like my vagina. So why is it called what it's called? What is the story behind this? Does it actually smell like Gwyneth Paltrow's vagina? So according to Paltrow herself in an interview with Seth Meyers, it started as a joke, she says. We were all messing around, but then I smelt this beautiful thing and I said, this smells like my vagina. She says, obviously I was kidding. We were on mushrooms. No, we weren't. We weren't. It just became funny to us and we thought it was a little bit punk rock. They were on mushrooms. It's fine. No, it's not fine. It's illegal. I honestly think this candle is quite cute. I think it's like a funny little thing. Let's get a, this smells like my penis, this smells like my armpits. Let's get the whole body range out. I'm all for it. But let's move on to the more troubling products. Now, these are two, I don't want to say iconic, but they for some reason did put Goop on the map. They're more troubling and harmful than anything. These two products were found on the Goop website, with one still being available on the Goop website, with one ultimately resulting in a lawsuit and a fine. Let's start off with DIY coffee enema kit. Do you remember there was a time period for some reason where everybody was going on about getting a colonic irrigation? It must have been like the early 2000s or maybe like 2010s. I can't remember. I associate Paris Hilton with them and I'm not sure why. They were on every makeover show, every reality show. People would not stop going on about colonic irrigation. And this is basically a procedure that involves washing out your colon and then extracting waste, like washing out with fluids and extracting waste. And the idea is, again, it's really based in pseudoscience. The idea is that you drain your body of waste and toxins. That's the key buzzword here, red flag word, toxins. It's actually a practice that has been around since ancient times. Like, you can trace this kind of thing back really, really far. And then, of course, the wellness industry jumped on that and throw in the word detox and toxins. So it makes sense that a website like Goop would sell your DIY Enema Kit, an at-home version of colonic irrigation. Rid your body of toxins, waste, detox, whilst also like steaming your bum hole, which I feel like is very goopy. But to cut a very long and predictable story quite short, there is no evidence that colonic irrigation enemas in general do anything. I don't know why people would voluntarily want to do this. I had a colonoscopy earlier this year. The prep for it was one of the most horrific things I've ever had to do. It was horrific, like horrific. The whole thing was actually quite interesting. Like the drugs were so good, I forgot it ever happened. So obviously when Goop started selling their own at-home DIY enema kit, not only that, but it was a coffee enema kit, people really started to kick off. But why do you want to start putting coffee up your bum hole? Like why would, what's it supposed to be good for? Apparently it's meant to be good for relieving constipation. I would just personally drink it. But the benefits that you could get from actually drinking a cup of coffee in no way is reflective of putting it up your bum hole in any way whatsoever. You do not reap those same benefits. So as I mentioned, people kicked off when they saw this, and not just because it was a stupid product or just because there was no evidence that it works, but although rare, coffee enemas have been linked to several deaths, with the Mayo Clinic listing several negative side effects, including dehydration, a tear in the rectum, infections, a change in your electrolyte balance, which they say can be dangerous if you have kidney or heart disease or other health problems. And this especially outraged a lot of the higher ups here in the UK who worked for the NHS, with NHS Chief Executive Sir Simon Stevens not only taking a stab at the Goop brand, but the wellness industry as a whole. He says that myths and misinformation have been put on steroids by the availability of misleading claims online. While the term fake news makes most people think about politics, people's natural concern for their health and particularly about their loved ones makes this particularly fertile ground for quacks, charlatans, and cranks. And now we have dubious wellness products and dodgy procedures available on the web. He says Gwyneth Paltrow's brand says chemical sunscreen is a bad idea and promotes colonic irrigation and DIY coffee enema machines, despite them carrying considerable risks to health, and NHS advice clearly stating there is no scientific evidence to suggest that there are any health benefits associated with colonic irrigation. Can you imagine like that being your expertise? Like you've studied for like years and years, maybe even a decade, to learn about the human body, what's good for it and what's not. And then some Hollywood A-lister comes, creates a website and tells you to shove things in your body that you shouldn't be putting up there, and people believe her more than you. But oddly enough, this wasn't the main product that really got Goop into trouble. It was a yoni eggs, jade and rose quartz eggs, that really landed Goop in trouble and in court, ultimately. So what are yoni eggs? Well, still currently available for sale on the Goop website. Goop and Gwyneth, I'm going to say this is all Gwyneth words because she oversees everything, says that yoni eggs harness the power of energy work. Energy work, crystal healing, and a kegel-like physical practice. They say, insert the egg into your vagina and feel the connection with your body by squeezing and releasing the egg. They go on to make really bold claims that these eggs can help strengthen the pelvic floor, increase bladder control, regulate your hormones, regulate menstrual cycles, and prevent uterine prolapse. Now, this isn't a Goop invention. Like the wellness industry tends to do, they tend to take things from other cultures, deep in history, and kind of make it into this very expensive, only rich people can afford kind of thing. It was initially believed that it was an ancient Chinese practice. However, upon doing research, there doesn't actually seem to be anybody who specializes in the area who says, yes, this is a ancient Chinese practice. There's just no evidence for it. And despite the plethora of advice, the tips and the medical kind of like miracles that a lot of other brands who sell this kind of stuff along with Goop make online, again, there is just no evidence that this is what shoving something up yourself and holding onto it can do. With this jade and rose quartz egg, potentially doing more harm than good. Speaking to health.com, Jennifer Gunter, MD, and OBGYN, and the author of the Vagina Bible, said that leaving a weight inside your vagina all day long isn't a healthy training method. She says you want to contract and relax, not have your muscles contract continually, said Dr. Gunter. Contracting constantly is like doing half of a bicep curl and not finishing it. And I believe the usage directions have changed, but one of the key things that made people like, what the fuck is this? It's because Gwyneth was like, put it in you and keep it on you all day. Like, try and hold it in all day. isn't there enough things going on at other times of the month that you don't want to, you know, it's not my place to comment. But I do find that this particular kind of wellness industry really does only target, and I'm going to say target women, almost like it's that fear-mongering thing of like, this is what can happen to your body with all these dangerous products and what your body goes through naturally. And here's an expensive natural way to heal it, you know? There's never anything targeted at men, which is not surprising, let's be honest. And as far as all the other claims and benefits that Goop claim, Dr. Gunter said that there's no truth. There's no truth, she says, purely because there is no such thing as magic. She also makes a really good point that even though these eggs are natural and even though, you know, they're made of stone and you can clean them, they're still really porous. So you can't exactly really give them a deep clean and can be very difficult to sterilize between uses. She says dangerous bacteria could get lodged into the nooks and crannies and then get reintroduced into the vagina every time the egg is used, referring to the bacteria that often causes things like toxic shock syndrome. So we have experts, real experts, basically saying, Gwyneth, Goop, everything you are saying here is a lie. Like, what the fuck are you talking about? So this is where the Orange County District Attorney's Office, who are a part of the California Food, Drug and Medical Device Task Force, had to get involved. On their website, they say the complaint alleged that Goop made unsubstantiated claims about the jade egg and rose quartz egg that were not supported by competent and reliable scientific evidence. Everything on Goop, that sentence just describes what she sells. Goop didn't really put up a battle here. They were like, yeah, you know what? They actually hadn't sold a lot of these eggs at the time. So we're like, fuck it, let's just get this over and done with. Let's pay a fine. And because of the small quantity of eggs they sold, they only had to pay back $145,000 in civil penalties. I believe they're worth over $200 million and were worth millions back then as well. So this really wasn't a dent in their bank. Goop then refunded the full price of purchase to anybody who did buy this jade or rose quartz egg, as well as their Inner Judge Flower Essence Bloom. Oh yes, the Inner Judge Flower Essence Blend. That was part of the lawsuit too. So they were selling a flower essence blend, and for $22, you could get a mixture of floral extracts that when ingested or added to bath water could help cure depression. This was described as a purifying organic floral blend that assists in the clearing of guilt, shame, self-criticism, and blame to help prevent shame spirals downward toward depressive states while enhancing equanimity. Whatever, I don't fucking care. What a load of fucking shit. I believe in aromatherapy, do not get me wrong. I believe that certain scents and oils and all that kind of stuff can make you feel in a certain way. It's a science, you know, like the smell they pump out outside like Cinnabon and in Disney World and stuff like that. But making these claims is it's craziness. But you know, she did it for a little while, everyone. Gwyneth Paltrow found a product that cured depression. Imagine talking to somebody about your depression, right? And they're like, oh, have you tried having a nice smelly bath? That would do it. That will cure your downward spiral. I think I'm done. I'm done with these products for one day. Let me know if you've ever bought anything off Goop, actually. I have been considering like doing a little shop on there and buying like the budget-friendly range of Goop products just to see what they're like. Do you believe in the power of crystal healing? If you do, would that mist technically work along the rules of crystal healing? Can you crush up crystals and put them in water and think they work? I don't know. Let me know in the comments down below. You watch some more videos here, some general light entertainment here, and I'll see you over there.